Welcome to Ocean Florida Liberty Church of God International.
Yeah. What's the name? Breaking the chain.
Please bless Quentin.
bless everybody to the whole wide world. Amen.
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 Amen. Thank you.
Please open your Bible to Leviticus 27:1-6. The Lord spoke to Moses. He said, speak to the people of Israel. Tell them, suppose someone makes a special promise to set a person apart to serve me. Here is how much it will cost to set that person free from the promise to serve. The cost for a male between the ages of 20 and 60 is 20 ounces of silver. It must be weighed out in keeping with a standard weight. There are you and the star did tip. The cost for female of the same age is 12 ounces of silver. The cost for a male between the ages 5 and 20 is 8 ounces of silver. The cost for the male of the same age is 4 ounces of silver. The cost between a male between the ages of 1 month and 5 months is a cost of silver. And the cost of female is 1 for an ounce of silver.
Amen. Amen.
Let's have open devotion service.
Give myself one.
I give myself
to you.
I give myself to you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Anybody else have a song or testimony?
About 5 seconds away to giving you the most amazing praise.
I will give you 5. I will give you 4. I will give you 3. 2. 1.
I'm about 5 seconds away to giving you the most amazing praise. I will give you 5, I will give you 4, I will give you 3, 2, 1, the world.
Amen.
Amen. That's how I do my
You know the song?
Yeah.
Which one you want to sing?
Just name one.
Okay.
Because of who you are.
I got a song. Anybody else have a song? I got a song. Go ahead, it's gonna sing.
Like the dew in the morning.
If you don't know the whole lyric, like the dew in the morning. I know what the
like the dew in the morning rests upon my heart.
The dew?
Yeah. No, I got another. Let me talk to you.
What is it?
Shirley Murdoch. Shirley Murdoch. Shirley Murdoch. You are my ministry.
You are my only true friend.
Please open your Bible to thank you, Lord, that we have another day to come into your temple and to come learn about you and live your and keep your glory and honor. Bless the people who are going through issues, people who's in a hospital in a surgery, people who's in a hospital bed and want to come to church. Bless the people who's at home, who's sick. In Jesus' name,
amen.
Submission, all is at rest.
Savior all the day long. So true it's Jesus is mine. Oh, what a fortress of glory divine. And of salvation, purchase of God. Spirit of His Spirit, washing His blood. This is my story. Of the community.
away from the people so he don't be around them. So he had to put him out of the group. And if someone eat meat that still has blood in it, it does not matter whether he is in the Zionite or an outsider. It turned against him if he eat. He will cut people out from the group. So, and you must not eat any meat that has blood in it. An outsider who is among you must not eat it either. And you have to throw the blood away with dirt or mud. And
amen. That was good.
Amen.
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 Ago. So that was very interesting to know what she learned during that time. And one of the things she said was very crucial when the Bible said, do not eat the blood of the animal. Because the blood of the animal has power in it, right? That's where the strength of the animal is at, right? All the animal strength, his energy and everything, is in the blood. That's our circuit. Through it, right? Right, Brother Curtis? You got something to say to everybody?
Amen.
Amen. Good. That's the point. So the blood have a lot of strength into it. That's why Jesus said, by my blood, by the blood of Jesus, you are healed, right? Because the blood of Jesus have power in it.
Amen.
And, you know what I'm saying? So therefore, God don't want you to eat no animal blood because some people may use it to do sacrifice or sacrifices, and therefore it is not right. Amen?
What about when people get transfusions?
That's not what I'm talking about. So therefore,
blood.
Amen. That's why blood is life. Without blood, you can't live. Talk about animal blood. Animal blood. Don't eat the blood of the animal. Okay? Because people use it for sacrifice and offering. But instead, when the animal died, put dirt over it. You know what I mean? When you cut the throat of the animal and the blood starts running, pour dirt over it. So that way you were not using it. You understand? And there's no way that you could use it for a sacrifice. Because the blood of the animal is the life of the animal. You understand? And without the blood of Jesus, you don't have life. Without the blood of Jesus covering you every single day of your life, you are no longer exist.
Amen.
So therefore, obey God's words, do what He says, and as you, I know people like to have their meat medium rare, have the blood good gut, a little bit of blood taking it, don't do it. So and because that also causes disease too anyway. That was another way to prevent disease from spreading around. Because the meat is ain't cooked, you easily get sick. And during that time, they was talking about, they was living in a camp area. So everybody was cramped up together. So disease was easily rapid. So that was a way for you to obey God's words. Amen? So let's continue on to obey God's words and do exactly as God said. Don't try to add our own interpretation of things to mess us up. Let's live according to what the Bible say, and don't try to make what the Bible say to really fit your version of your life when it's not exactly that. Okay? So anybody else have something to say? Did I answer your question, Brother Curtis?
No, you did.
Thank you very much. Do you have something to add?
You did, but you really didn't answer my question. You were talking about animal blood.
Yeah. We don't drink human blood. So therefore we don't have to worry about it.
What about transfusion?
That's human, but that's through one person. But the Bible's talking about animals. The blood of animals, not the blood of humans.
So that's fine.
Blood of humans.
If it's a medical reason, yeah, it's fine. Amen.
Amen.
Sister Christina?
Yeah.
have in Jesus. So if you do not know Jesus and you want to have him as your friend, it is the time to say, but right now I'm relinquishing everything. I want to find that friend, right? Because Jesus said that he is your friend. He's the only one that's going to be there for you. You may think you have friends, but in actuality, you do not have friends. But the only friend you really, really have is Jesus. So if you know that, amen?
Amen!
If you know that Jesus is your only friend, that's the reason why we have service every Sunday. Even though we don't say no to, you know, to give your life to Christ all the time, but I say, you know, today, if you feel like right now, you want to give your life to Christ, this is the time to do it. If you feel like you want a friend in your life, you don't have a friend, this is the time to get that friend. Because if you believe in your heart that Jesus born again, right? And he rose from the dead, and he is the Son of God, and you're ready to accept him as your Lord and Savior, right? Jesus will be that friend for you. But if you still say, I don't know if Jesus is the Son of God, how come Jesus be a Son of God and still be God? How come this and how come that? You're still doubting the power of God into your life. Then you're going to miss the opportunity to have Jesus as your friend. Amen? See, the point goes to go for it. So therefore, if you want to serve God, it is the time to do it. If you want to have that friend that you can call 24/7, 7 days a week, 365 a year, no problem, every day, every night, phone number never get disconnected, you know, his line never busy when you call on his name. This is the time to say, you know, I acknowledge that Jesus is the Son of God and I want him as my friend. You don't have to come up, you could just say that to yourself, right? Amen.
Amen.
You could say that to yourself. And God will be there, and Jesus will be there to accept you and to adopt you into the family of God. Amen. At this time, let's sing one more song. You want to tithe? If you have the tithe offering, you want to bring up, you can. And if you don't, it's okay.
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know if I'm going to do it.
Oh.
And I got money from the tithe. Can I get a basket?
Yeah, get the basket and bring it by.
Okay. Going around.
Good.
Sit down.
Somebody get my tie.
There is a
Oh, how I love you.
first person, as the song said, he first loved you, right? So if you say you love God, this is his time to do it. We didn't have a baptism. Yeah, I'm planning on having one soon. So if somebody want to sign up for one, let me know. As the Bible said, you must be baptized. Not only you must accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, right? I'm still talking. Not only you must accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, that's one. After you accept Jesus, you must baptize. That's two. So that way, you would, by baptize, you wash away that old self and you rise up with Christ, right? That old sin is washed away and you become new with Christ, right? So therefore, just like Stefan did, right? He accept Christ, and that same minute he baptized, just like John the Baptist was doing. He, you know, the people accept Christ, and then he baptized them, right? And Jesus himself was baptized by John the Baptist. So therefore, you must be baptized. So not only say that, you know. So if you want to, let me know. So I could partner up with another church who's doing baptism, so we could get baptized together. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let's bow our head as we pray. Sister Christina is going to give grace. And Sister Lamira.
She said, I don't feel good.
Sister Lamira, are you okay? Okay, that's good. And Chatty Junior. Excuse me. I see you are happy today. Is anybody hot enough today in the room?
No.
They're hot enough?
No.
But nobody realized the AC was right there. Nobody turned on the AC.
That
was cooking
us
up in this room.
I was telling you to turn
the AC?
Yep.
Oh.
Well, you got to be hot. Permission.
I guess y'all going to be hot for a while then.
Okay, turn the AC.
Amen. So, okay, so let's bow our head as we pray. Sister Christina going to do grace for us.
What up, chat?
Shut up. I'm still waiting for y'all to stop. Bow our head as we pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you and we praise you and we adore you. We want to give. Thank you for giving us one more day to praise you, to worship, to come to your table, to glorify your name. Because without you, we wouldn't be here today. Without you waking us up this morning, we wouldn't be here. Without you watching our every footstep, we wouldn't be here. Without you guiding us today, we wouldn't be here. Because you are a loving God, you are a merciful God, amen. When the sunrise was risen, amen, you let the sun come in, amen, and you blessed us and you was able to wake us up. And we thank you and we praise you, amen. Hallelujah, Father. As we're about to go home, Father, watch over every last one of us, guide us, protect us, and let us come back again to praise and to worship your name. So we give you the glory, amen. Bless everyone that came into church today. Bless those who was thinking of coming to church but didn't make it. Bless those, amen, who are in need among us. Bless those who are sick among us, amen. And give them that special healing and benediction that they are looking for, amen. And bless every one of us, amen, who is sick, amen, amen. Bless every one of us who is sick, Father, and watch over us and guide us, amen. Hallelujah, Father, bless those who are in the hospital right now who is sick. Bless those who are looking for healing, amen, amen, don't know how to get it, amen. Bless those, amen, wherever they may be. Bless those who are persecuted for your name's sake. In Jesus' mighty name, we praise you. Amen, amen, and amen.
Amen.
My heart,
Amen. Amen. Amen.